cake. Shut the fuck up, do what daddy say. I think I got a little baby mad at me. Fucked up ass, she the bad today. Told her I'm in the way, we can go get it fixed. I'ma drop the bitch off of my sister, she the shit. As soon as she down with your nappy ass, hey, call up your buddy, come pick up his bitch. Damn, look at my wrist, that's a pick. I just fucked up my Rolex, but fuck it, it's a...
I got it. I'm trying to get it. Hold on. One thing I don't play about is my motherfucking sleep. Everybody know that about me. But I will straight snap and kill you. If I wake up in too early, I'm in the motherfucking sleep. Man, I used to be in this relationship with this person. And he, when he would wake up, he would want me to wake up with him. So what he would do is purposely make noise, drop stuff, kick the bed, like, and keep getting up in and out of the bed. That's how you know, that's a perfect sign, y'all, that somebody has an evil, wicked spirit. Because anybody who know you tired and know you done had a hard fucking day and they purposely trying to get your ass up just for their own benefit or their own meaning, they got problems. Look out for them. I'm telling y'all this for a fucking reason, because somebody need to hear it. It ain't no reason why the fuck I'm recording this. Y'all, people give you signs off bat, little signs off bat, that something ain't right with them. I really be questioning some of y'all niggas, like, y'all really want that kind of image? Like, y'all really want that kind of lifestyle? Like, I hope you know that leads to nothing. Haven't you seen that in your life, in your family, your friends? Look around. People older than you still doing what you doing and they ain't got nowhere. They might got a little bit of spending money, a little bit of chump change, but that's it. You notice they ain't never been nowhere major. They ain't never done nowhere major. They never done anything major. They ain't never been a part of nothing major. It's a pattern. Y'all need to pay attention to patterns. Stop going with your generational curses. Like, ugh, wake up. Some of y'all just stupid. I'm like, wow, really? You see a generational curse in your family, then you just fall along with it. And you think that shit is okay, and you think that... And another thing, man, I ain't gonna say no names, but this dude was on his motherfucking page talking about folks. And I'm like, you really got enough to talk. Because when people mention your name in the streets, all they say is, you got 101 kids and you can't maintain a job. Like, are you serious? And you want to act superior? You want to talk about other folks? Really? You ain't got no room to talk about nobody. Considering. Please. I've been looking at some of y'all like, really? You ain't got no room to talk. Look around at where you at. Take a look off the snap and look around at where you at. Man, let me tell y'all something. I had this situation where this person was trying to talk to me, right? So, of course, you do your research. You like, okay, let me figure out who this motherfucker is. Let me see. This was a while back. And I did my research and I found out who the fuck they was. And I'm like, This nigga is a pass around nigga, a hot potato. Don't nobody want no hot potato ass nigga. Like, come on. You really think I was gonna take you serious? Boy, come on. Now I understand that's the thing with being single. You can do whatever you want. But that don't mean you can't be no passed around hot potato ass nigga. Niggas can be passed around too, trust me. Let me tell y'all something else. Every nigga that I've been in school with, done tried to talk to me. And I told him, hell no. Hell the fuck no. Half of them sick, half of them on drugs, half of them doing more pills than a little bit, and you can tell. Fucking looks sick as fuck. Diseased out. Looking fucking raggedy as hell. Disgusting. Have nothing to offer. Broke. There's only one nigga that I would probably talk to that I went to school with. And only because he has ambition and he has drive. And I have seen that. And he watched my snap. You know who he is. He's probably the only one dude that I would probably take serious. The rest of y'all, get the fuck out of here. Look at you. Another thing. Don't lie. This Rocky Mount. Don't lie. Motherfuckers talk too goddamn much around here. Niggas talk too goddamn much around here. For you to try to lie to me. Man. Niggas talk more than bitches these days. Like, that shit is so fucking true. They'll tell you everything you want to fucking know. I guarantee you. So don't think you're going to lie to me. Now, let me say this, and then I'm going to wrap this shit up. This is going to be the end of this shit. I'm not judging anybody who deals drugs or sells drugs. Y'all some hustlers. I'm talking about the bum-ass ones. The ones that sell a damn nick bag this all and ain't getting nothing but a couple of dollars. I'm talking about the ones fronting like they really be out there. Because I got a lot of people who actually sell drugs that watch me. I got a bunch of drug dealers. Shout out to y'all. Because y'all the real MVPs. But I'm talking about the ones who be out there fronting with their monies all in the pictures and showing everybody. You don't show now. Y'all know the police. Some of y'all some idiots. Don't be. I'm telling you, the police is everywhere. But I just want to shout out to all the drug dealers that watch me. Y'all the real MVPs. Like I said, I fucks with y'all. And y'all know if I need anything, I will hit y'all the fuck up. Because I rock with y'all. Thank you for supporting me. Thank you for motherfucking watching me. You know what I'm saying? And turn the fuck up. And keep doing what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? Because y'all real motherfucking hustlers out there trying to make a way for your goddamn family. And I appreciate that. Happy birthday, dear Lily. Yeah, you too. Happy birthday to you. How old are you?
6.
Good job.